like a nomad, a straight up course. You said trust you, not to worry. Upon our knees, we will.
Come on, sit down. Be comfortable. So you're my new roommate. What's your name? You're so cute.
I'm Chelsea.
Hi, Chelsea. I'm Natasha, so I can tell this is your first year here, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, but I'm actually kind of excited.
You should be. I got you. I know the hottest spots, the best parties, my way around campus.
Thanks a lot, but I don't know. I don't usually go and do all that stuff. But I did hear there's a great youth group here somewhere on campus.
It's cool. I've been there a couple of times. But, you know, you're all grown up now. You need to do new things.
I mean, I guess, but, you know, I just got here. I think I need to settle in first.
Don't worry. We're going to have so much fun. I'm so happy we're roommates. So, where are you from?
I came from New York.
Where in New York?
From Brooklyn.
I've been there so many times. They have the finest boys, let me tell you.
Not really.
Why? Have you ever had a boyfriend?
Hey, guys. So, welcome to youth group. My name is Jackie. I know you guys are all stoked for this upcoming school year. I see some new people, new faces. That's pretty cool. I just wanted to let you all know that this is a great campus and a great fellowship, and you'll meet a lot of people. However, there is something in my heart, because the people that you associate yourself with can either bring you up or bring you down. But that's okay, because you can still forgive yourself even if you've fallen into temptation. But before we get into detail, let's just go around and introduce ourselves and get a little bit more acquainted. So, you know, there's this thing that goes like this. Show me your friend and I'll tell you the kind of person you are. Now, in Proverbs 13:20, it says, walk with the wise and become wise. Associate with the foolish and get yourself into trouble.
Hey, girl, how are you?
What's up?
What's going on?
Oh my gosh, so I heard about this popping kickback in Jester Dorm Friday night.
I heard
night.
About it too. It's gonna be so live. I cannot wait.
Yes.
Who's your cute little friend over here?
This is my new roommate, Chelsea.
Hi, Chelsea.
Hey, Chelsea. Yeah, so I'm about this kickback. So I heard there's gonna be a twerking competition.
Girl.
$20 for the winner.
I heard it was gonna be bundles.
Yes, bundles, and bottles, and just the
Chelsea, loosen up. It's gonna be so much fun.
I got
fun.
You, girl.
I promise. We'll be with you the whole time.
Mm-mm. I got a couple guys lined up for you already.
All lined up.
Let me tell you. Seniors. I'm not talking about no freshmen.
So your friends can either make or break you. When they fall, you fall, and that can be a major pitfall in life. However, you don't need to let that bring you down. Because just because you fell doesn't mean you can't get yourself back up. Because the fight isn't over, so forgive yourself, because God forgives.
Anyway, so I really feel like this party is just what we need. Chilling, letting go.
Exactly, but don't get too excited. It's not like you're gonna remember what you did tonight anyway.
True. So, Chels, I think you should come to the party too. It's gonna be so much fun. You get to meet new people, make new friends.
I mean, I don't know. School just started. I honestly think I should just kind of, you know, lay low for a little bit.
Lay low. When you get back up, no one's gonna want to hang out with you. Come on, freshman.
Yeah, relax a little bit. It's gonna be fun. I mean, I guess I'll come.
So let me tell you this one time, me and Carl went to this one party. I have to get up for this because it's that serious.
it was so much fun.
We walked in. I have like.
And although you can always find your way back to Christ, the risk can be deadly. Any questions?
I got what
the solution.
Here, here you go. Take one of these. No, I need you to take one.
I got it.
Okay.
I got it.
Okay.
I got
look,
it.
She's gonna do it. It. She'll be just
look.
Fine. It's not gonna hurt. See?
Uh-huh.
It's really that easy.
That's amazing.
Take one. You will loosen up, I promise. It's not gonna hurt you. Drink up. This will help you loosen up. Come on, girl. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right.
Get it.
Go, Charmin. Go, Chelsea. Go, Charmin. Go, Chelsea. Get it.
Kind of tense here on campus today. I mean, I've just been getting all these nasty looks.
Are you seriously worried about them? We had fun. Friday was cool. I mean, Friday was fun, wasn't it?
No, I don't even remember half of what happened that night.
I mean, you're kind of a household legend now.
So Chelsea, I see you're getting quite acquainted to the campus life and this secular atmosphere.
Wait, I don't understand. All we did was have a little get-together.
Have a little get-together? I don't know what you call that, but that was no little get-together. I guess you haven't checked Snapchat lately.
Snapchat? Well, I mean, I haven't been on there in weeks, but...
I would suggest that you get on there, because that was 200 seconds of absolute nonsense.
Was I really that bad?
Look, I'm your friend, and I'm not gonna sugarcoat it for you. That was embarrassing, and it's doing nothing for your Christian rep.
Well, I mean, the whole Christian thing wasn't really for me anyway.
So it's better with hanging around with bad influences and hitting rock bottom?
What is wrong with you? Why are you acting so holier than thou? Just because you don't know how to have fun, it doesn't mean you should stop her from having her own fun.
Look, I am literally begging you, please don't do this to her. She can't handle it. I know Chelsea better than anyone, better than she even knows herself. And I know she can't handle this. And I know that when she hits rock bottom, no one will be able to help her. Not even you or me. So please stop this.
Don't deserve any of this treatment that anyone is giving me, okay? Especially my so-called best friend, Debbie. But you know what? If people really think I'm that crazy, I'll show them how crazy I can really be.
Somebody like you could change so quickly. It's insane, but I think I like it.
Thanks, guys, but this isn't just the side of me. It's who I am now.
Well, doesn't it feel weird not being the church-going, Bible-thumping girl that we thought you were?
You know what, guys? Lay off of Chelsea. Besides, she said it herself. That whole church-going Jesus thing was just a facade.
Thanks, Natasha. So now this is why you're my best friend. And you're the only one who truly understands me. And honestly, I'm just grateful you're in my life. I don't have to hide myself anymore.
Man, forget all that noise. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's nothing to hide. You know what I'm saying? Like, you are who you are. So just embrace it. And you've been really open to trying some new things. Like, it's not a boy and girl world anymore. And plus, people come to college to try some new things anyway. I mean, you did some things with me and Leslie. I didn't kill you.
Besides, gay marriage is legal now in America. People need to embrace this generation and get with it.
Okay. You know what? Let's go celebrate this new Chelsea. I know a place to go tonight. Let's get turned.
Yeah!
Now, baby, won't you come my way?
Of control. Your life is so extreme now. We were having fun at first. We were going out. But now look at you. You're popping pills every day.
Wait. Since when did you turn into Debbie? Okay, you used to be fun and a great person to hang out with. Now you're just kind of nagging me.
I'm not Debbie. I'm helping you. We were about having fun before, but now you're just crazy. You know what? If you want help, go get it. But if you want to kill yourself, I'm not going to be a part of it.
Natasha. And Natasha. Well, I mean, if she wants to walk out on me, I guess I didn't really need her anyway. I mean, I just have myself now.
Come out of sadness from wherever you've been. Let rescue begin. Come find your mercy.
Sister. We spent so much time growing up together. I just can't believe she's gone.
I'm so sorry. I don't even know where to begin. I didn't even know her that well at first. I just wanted to have fun and I led her into things she shouldn't have been doing. I'm so sorry.
I can't believe it. My sister, my only sister, my only sibling is gone. And I don't understand where things went wrong, but from all that you told me, I understand why she wanted me to stay away from her. She didn't want me to know, and I wish that I did so I could have done something to save her, but I couldn't. All I know is that God is in control.
I don't understand. Your sister is dead because of what I did, and you're still sitting here talking to me about God. God can't have a place for people like me. I don't understand. You're so nice and I did all of this.
It's okay, Natasha. I forgive you. God forgives you. But all what you have to do is turn to Him. You're still here, aren't you? You're a living testimony. Why don't you turn to Him?
What? I still don't understand. Your sister is dead because of me. She is dead, right?
See, I know this may sound crazy, but I was kind of like you until I buckled down and I realized Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior. And I know you've probably heard about Him once or twice in your life, and just let me explain to you His importance to you in our lives. He came here to die for our sins. And he has so much love and mercy, it's so unrealistic. If God can forgive the people who murdered him on the cross, how much more can he forgive you? You have many similar traits to my sister, and I don't want you to go down the same path she did. Would you like to give your life to Christ?
Praise your mercy toward me, your loving kindness toward me, your tender mercies I see day after day, and forever faithful towards me, always providing for me. Great is your mercies towards me. Great is your grace. Your tender